What do we got here? Fucking dweebs.
Fucking dweebs. The Triple X Oblivion. Fucking dweeb. Says, that dude on the right is a knuckle dragger. There's nothing going on upstairs except durr. Fucking caveman. Laugh my ass off.
Dude on the right, though, is that me or you?
No,
that's when we switched.
This video, it's me.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
knuckle dragger. Only fucking knuckles I'm dragging is my balls over your mom's clit when I fuck her from behind, Oblivion. Hi! I'm Chris.
And I'm Pete. And this is
Metalheads
React
to hip-hop. Fuckface.
Fucking diet earthlings. Just like that. Alright, so what do we got here? Lil Wayne, Mona Lisa featuring Kendrick Lamar.
Oh dear.
This is from Lil Wayne's new album, right?
Yeah, I believe so.
So yeah, we were curious about this anyway, but
Everyone's been asking for Kendrick Lamar.
So
everything I hear from Kendrick Lamar, I typically don't really enjoy. I haven't heard him do like standalone songs. I always hear him as like a guest feature in someone else's song, as is the case with this. So, but I do know that I really like Lil Wayne a lot.
I used to like his old. He's been around a while, right?
Yeah.
But yeah, I don't know Kendrick Lamar at all.
This.
Okay, here we go.
There's lyrics.
This is supposed to be a lyric video. So
I got a story to tell, you know that I cherish these. Hope it ain't too many feelings involved. I see niggas in this bitch stuntin', popping bottles, getting drunk with these bitches, and when they leave, they get followed. Fall asleep with that bitch and really don't know much about her. Then she let us in, we take all of your shit, and when you wake up, she help you try to find it. I love her. I be with bitches, that be with bitches, that be with niggas with riches. I tell her get him, she say I got you. I say no bitch, I say get him. And they so pretty, and they hair lengthy. He hit it and sleep on her titties. And she give us the worry, come through with AKs. It's a stick up, she scream like a victim, not you. Feeling so silly, I smoke color purple. I'm up in here feeling like silly. Ooh, nappy ass dress, what's that you say? Watch your mouth, Millie Vanilli. Ooh, you can get snakes, you can get faced out by the bitch that you feeling. Cause you thought she was an angel. That bitch ain't no angel. I treat her halo like a frisbee and you.
Not really revving my engine so far.
No, not at all.
There's an excessive amount of the word bitch.
Yeah.
He uses the word bitch like,
That's not Lil Wayne, is it?
I think that's Lil Wayne.
Oh, is it? Yeah.
It's not the typical Lil Wayne style that I'm familiar with. It's not like, like 6 foot, 7 foot, or things like that.
Yeah, I don't... the flow is weird, too.
I like the way I like their production so far. I like the beat, but I like the way they're throwing heavy delay in like specific parts, almost to make the vocal line become the beat. Like the delay almost makes it percussive.
Yeah, that's true.
I don't really like what's being presented, but I like how it's being presented. if that makes any sense. But that's only a minute in, so
let's keep it going.
Tell her your business, thought she was an angel. That bitch ain't no angel, I treat her halo like a frisbee. And you, tell her your business, she tell me your business. You tell that bitch what you feeling. All of the beans you be spilling. To you, she lied through her tea cavities feeling. She know where you had it, tell me where it's hidden. She know when you gone, tell me when to visit. We breaking your home, and take the specifics to me. While the bitches on vacation with him, so she don't get blamed. We don't snatch chains, we find out addresses, and we don't leave messes. You'll only know that it's gone when you check it. Then your first thought is to start second guessing. She say what's wrong, he say nothing, keep resting. She say was missing, how you know something missing? He scratched his head, she said, get back in bed. And she gave him some head, but you can't trust them bitches. And then she say, ooh, I see niggas in this bitch.
This flow is killing me.
Yeah, I didn't like it.
It's...
I thought you said you liked it, though. Whoa, how it went with the beat or something. Oh, no, the delay stuff. Just the delay stuff.
Like the beat elements and, like...
Yeah, it's very like repetitive or something.
It also flow, seems right? like really, really like compressed. His voice seems like squished.
Yeah, the sound of it is a little like hollow or something.
Yeah.
Too. Yeah, I have a few problems with this already, but
I don't like. It seems like he's kind of like walking away from a traditional flow to make it fit the lyric. Like, yeah. I don't know, but it seems like he wrote all the lyrics first and then said, well, I've got to make it fit this song.
I know what you mean.
Where, you know, like, you write a really good riff and you're, like, eager to use it, but you misplace it because you're eager to use it.
Yeah. Yeah, not that everything has to vary, but this is just so, like,
yeah.
There's no breath or something, right?
Then the bar ends, like... It doesn't correspond to...
Yeah, then there's, like, space at the end, right?
Yeah, it doesn't really... I don't know.
Procrustean.
Like, it's not...
They're trying to, like, fit it in anyways.
Like, I don't want to say that I can tell what they're trying to do, but it... Like, I have an inkling. It just doesn't seem like it's working out for me.
Yeah, if I heard this on the radio, I would just turn it immediately.
You would have turned the channel, yeah.
But we have to...
Yeah, we have to... Three, four.
Yeah, it's not engaging at all.
Popping bottles, getting drunk with these bitches, and when they leave, they get followed.
That's the chorus.
I be with bitches that know the bitches. That's what the niggas we following. Get them on the line, stay two cars behind, and tell them hoes don't be so obvious. Mona Lisa, long hair don't care. She handles the business and don't ever tell. She bite the bullet and cuff up the shell. She tell him, ooh, daddy, let's go to your place. And if he say yeah, then we meet him there. She feed him lies with his silverware. She don't want love, she just want to share.
That's not bad.
You like that, the lyrics?
Yeah.
Let's go back to it. You know, I was honing in on the beat. Because I like the beat a lot, actually.
Yeah, that's my favorite part so far.
Mm. There's a lot going on with the organ. There's like some cool stuff.
Also, I think the beat sounds dramatic, and the storytelling is wanting. So there seems to be like kind of discrepancy between a beat that's like heavy. Mm. The beat sounds like emotional, but the lyrics, for the most part, is
yeah, bitches it's about and bitches, like heist or whatever. Yeah. Well, they're like setting up these dudes to rip them off. Is that what's happening?
I couldn't tell you, but I do.
Well, yeah,
like
it seems like she's involved with these guys who are like, she's getting like into the house, and then they're like robbing it, or whatever. Isn't
she tell him, "Oh, daddy, let's go to your place," and if he say yeah, then we meet him there. She feed him lies with his silverware. I like that.
You like that? Feed him lies with his silverware.
She don't want love; she just want her share.
Yeah, no, that's the silverware line is good.
Yeah, I know a bitch named Liz. This nigga thinks she is because you tell him that it is, so he tell her all his secrets.
I know a bitch named Liz, too.
Me too.
He tell her all his fears, and then she tell me, and I be all ears. Then I go and tell my people, and they already know him. And then I call Liz, and she say, you coming over. I said, good girl, just remember what I told you. She gave me the salute. I said, girl, you're a soldier. We waiting outside, watch him pull up, walk up to the door. And right before he knocked, she opened the door naked. She left it unlocked. They started French kissing, so he didn't see moi. Then she let him in. They stopped on the couch.
The fuck is this?
What?
This is a stream of consciousness. Don't lift a pen off the paper. Just keep going.
But I get the story. That's what's happening. She's like helping these dudes rob these. I mean, whatever.
Yeah.
Just let them in.
But like this thing happened, and then this thing happened,
yeah, I know,
and then this thing happened, and then this thing happened.
I wish there was more breath or something. There's no phrasing really. It's all just like.
That's a really good way of putting it.
It's yeah, like, I feel like
there's no phrasing. Yeah,
you know, like when you, I feel like space is important.
Well, like from a metalhead standpoint, if that's what we are, I mean, you're creating. These lyrics are the riffs. You know, the elements that are creating the hook.
Yeah, it's a central element,
and I mean, you can play a really. You can play a really great riff and have it come out terribly boring with absent or poor phrasing. You know, like the difference between a note being bent a quarter step.
Sure.
And just being played
lackadaisically. Yeah.
And then at the same time, you can play a three-note riff, like totally wrought with emotion, with brilliant phrasing.
Hmm.
And but it's like, it's super simplistic. this needs phrasing. That was a smart way to put it.
Yeah, I think so. And I think, like, there's a Miles Davis quote where he says, it's not the notes you play, it's the notes
note you don't play. Yeah.
And I think this is the case, like, when to, like, not...
playing too many notes.
Yeah, it's too much, like, coming at you all at once, and there's no, like, breath.
Yeah.
Because the breath, what that does is, like, makes you reflect upon what was just said.
Yeah.
It gives you time to sort of... And it just feels more natural. This feels, like, unnatural in a way.
There's no instance for you to sit inside the story being told, and it's not being told eloquently enough for you to really sink into it as it's happening. You're just kind of left going, and then.
Yeah, and the way, like you said, like, lyrics are so lackluster, like... Music up loud and his head in the clouds. Like, that's fucking second grade shit. Like, let's face it, you know what I mean?
Yeah, like, no, I'm sorry, but that's what it is. Yeah.
Like, if you just read this on a page, you'd be like, this is fucking horrible.
Yeah, like, I'm not finishing this book. Yeah.
But anyway, let's keep
going. Music up loud with his head in the clouds. Turning shit down and I scared a piss out him. Piss a nigga off, put the gun to his frown. Nigga turn around, I ain't hit a fuck around. I ain't hit a fuck around, caught you with your pants down. You know what it is, put your fucking hands up. Liz, that's enough, you can put your hands down. Then he looked dead at her and he shook his head at her. She a good actress and you a dead actor. You'll be dead after we get what we...
I need a palate cleanser.
Yeah, seriously. Something, man.
Confront me, unholy one, bastard saint, son of the earth. I summon thee, now poison me, death of the world, burn of my soul. Liz call you daddy, she about to be a bastard. Oh, I got way too many bitches that do anything for me, nigga, but thank for me, nigga. Send her to you like she ain't for me, nigga. I hope you alone like bankruptcy, nigga. She pour you a drink that drank on me, nigga. She slipped something in and I bank for me, nigga. Mona Lisa, I done painted the picture. Mona Lisa out the frame on these niggas. Pussy got you out of character, nigga. You fall for these hoes up your ladder, my nigga. Take everything that you have to. You don't even have an opinion. We have your attention and now you looking on a barrel, oh, nigga. Now she looking for her pantyhose, nigga. We just looking for the casserole, nigga. But she gon'...
Go back.
No, that's right. And the beat comes out. Take everything that you have till you don't even have an opinion. We have your attention. Of course you have our attention. You took the beat out. Telling us you is right. A redundancy. It's like you put a highlighter on a highlighter. What? This is bumming me out because I typically like Lil Wayne.
I've heard it's earlier.
He's always fun. And this just isn't fun. The beat is pretty cool. I like that.
The beat
flute
is good. I like the beat a lot, actually. Yeah, a little touch.
Now you looking on a barrel, nigga. Now she looking for her pantyhose, nigga. We just looking for the casserole, nigga. But she gonna show us where you stash it, though, nigga. Mama. Every day she wake up with a different color makeup and a promise he could take her to the movie in the mall. Chilling with the liquor on the floor for a quarter for a minute on the clock. Black mama with the bow. Paparazzi looking at them both popping up and take a picture. Probably on the internet blog. In a minute he gonna be admitting that he love her on his mother. Man, he wanna meet her mother by tomorrow. Mona Lisa, pussy good enough. He got him sitting in the walls and he digging in it like he living in it. Make a new religion with him and a nigga about to go against God. Portrait in the bad tree, sweet tone like a hummingbird. When she asked him, did he wanna make love in a yellow taxi? Never gave two fuck, jumped in the backseat. Woke up in the morning to the great Gatsby. Then he dogged it again like the bitch last seat. I'm a dog in the wind, I'm a pit laughing. I'ma call up again like I did last week. Make good with a friend and I'm all jazzy. Britney with a twin and a girl Ashley. Found out that I fucked, he was unhappy. Bitch, I never let the bullshit get past me. Better yet, I wanna break up. Don't you ask me, but a motherfucking double standard acting. Fucking on another nigga, that's a negative alone. But you suck this dick, that's just nasty. Matter of fact, bitch, give me your phone.
No.
You fucking with Wayne.
No.
Bitch, give me your phone.
No. Let me take this call real quick.
Dude. Touching yourself, looking at Kendrick videos up on the internet, watching his interviews. I don't know what the fuck lately got into you. Tell me who love you. I bet I love harder. Forgot all the shit that I did for your daughter. The pampers, the PDA light, and my mama daycare at the school, and she never did charge her. You scandalous as fuck, and I hope you blow up. You know what? I get bucked. Let me go get my gun. I got one in the chamber. I'm planning no aiming. God damn it, you know that the damage is done. Bitch, I'm emotional cause I'm in stress. I'm not supposed to go through this, I guess. So in conclusion, since you like rappers, that's killing their.
I have to go back. Cause I'm not. What's happening? All right, we'll just keep it going.
Exactly. What's happening? there's been like four different vocal style changes, but like full verses of like, no, we just, it's almost like saying like, well, we want you to do this scene with a British accent, and then we want you to do this scene as a woman.
It's bizarre. Like, yeah. Like, I know what's happening, but it's like, it's just like a, it's like a mess, right?
I'm quite surprised by the fact that when Kendrick came in strongly, this was the highlight for me so far.
Yeah, me too. I thought I would like the Lil Wayne portion.
He had pretty decent flow. But I wasn't crazy about the lyrics, but it was creative, and it was very smooth.
Some of the lines were good, I thought.
But at the same time, it's not saving the song. Right? Yeah. Was it disjointed? Is that what
disjunct,
you
said?
Yeah. Yeah.
And the beat changed, but it was like, this is making me appreciate that Immortal Technique. Is that the one? The Devil, what was that called? The one with the story that was pretty dark.
Dancing with the Devil.
Dancing with the Devil. Like, that story was told much better than this, obviously.
Yeah.
And it's making me appreciate that more. Because that was similar in a way. It's telling this pretty long story, this intricate story.
Yeah, and with that one it was a really long drawn out story. It was kind of, but yeah, it was like Taxi Driver, where it really got intense towards the end.
Yeah.
And you had to sit through it to really get it to make sense to you. Because he's telling one long drawn out story, and the cadence and the tempo where everything was the same throughout. Mm. And it was steady, and you could count on it. Which, if you don't see it all the way through, will probably come off as a little bit boring.
Yeah.
But here, the opposite's happening, and it's distracting me. There's a bunch of different, like, the beat's good, where I didn't really like the beat in the other one that much.
Right, right.
The beat here came is good, and all the different deliveries are making me feel...
Yeah, that like one definitely, like, structurally had more direction to it.
Yeah.
This feels, like, kind of all over the place.
Well, the other one seemed like it was, like...
It was more well
like
thought out.
Like, monothematic. We're like, we've got one vision. This is where the entirety of the story is headed.
Right.
And this is like, all well, we could go here, or here, or all these places.
Pussy, I'm killing she myself! Said, ooh, daddy, ooh, Mona Lisa, Mona Lisa.
Yeah.
Ooh, daddy, smile, Mona Lisa, Mona Lisa. She said, ooh, daddy, motion, Mona Lisa, Mona Lisa.
Thank God.
Yeah, that was not good.
Didn't like that.
Nah.
Cool beat.
The beat was great.
A lot of fun beat. Could have done a lot of different things on top of that, but...
Yeah.
Could have done a lot of different things on top of that.
But I think... Yeah, let's go to the rubric, right?
I think we have to.
We'll sort it out.
Sort the rubric.
So, lyrical flow. I'll go first because...
Because everyone likes you. You're on the left.
This pen is not... Notice I'm using the...
special the Hobbit pen.
That doesn't really work, but... I didn't really like the flow until... Yeah, some of the Kendrick Lamar, at least the cadence of it and the tempo got kind of interesting. But before that, I was getting really bored with the flow. And I think, yeah, just all in all, it wasn't that engaged with it.
Like, there wasn't any hook for the bulk of it.
No.
It seemed kind of like...
Just like...
You know when some of these morons leave us a shitty comment and it's like one huge run-on sentence and there's no punctuation and it's like three paragraphs and there's not a single comma or a period or anything. That's what those verses from Lil Wayne were like. It was like this thing, then 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 this thing. And you're like, why are you doing it?
It wasn't very, I mean, we'll get into lyrical content, but... Yeah, we're just flow-wise, just very...
You watching this, Connor McFetridge?
Yeah, it was very monotonous.
Fuck you!
Why, did he want to
No, say? I'm just yelling at Connor.
You like saying his name.
Yeah.
But I don't know, yeah, did you feel a similar way about the flow?
Yeah, especially because I know Lil Wayne can do so much better.
Yeah, I've liked what I've heard before.
Yeah.
But you said it was, like, different for him, even the flow, right?
Well, I mean...
I mean, I don't know.
It's been a while.
Super familiar with
it's been a while since I've sit down and listened to
yeah,
like a full album of his. But like his bigger, you know, the tracks that you could hear accidentally because they're just popular, or they're always like, they're like, there's like a snappiness to them. This one kind of seemed like the equivalent of like when a band that you like is really heavy tries to do a ballad and it doesn't work out.
It was like lackluster for me.
Yeah.
Mostly.
It was like, it almost seemed like an attempt at drama, but without.
So how do we rate the flow? Do we average out the two different?
I don't think you can. Because even after Kendrick came in, he did his part that was quicker and snappier, and it was fun, but it was very short-lived. And then they went for that totally other direction where it sounded like they were trying to get the feminine vocal line.
Yeah, it was so out of place, right?
Yeah, it came in like
pulled from everything. They're trying to tell a serious story.
Abruptly, and then, oh, we're talking like this now.
Yeah, because the rest of the story is kind of serious, sort of.
Yeah.
But, you know what I mean? Yeah, and then it got kind of silly at the end. And then it totally lost any sort of effect that it had.
So yeah, like, I mean, so overall, if the scale is 0 to 10, then the 2 or 3 of it was good from Kendrick, but the rest of it wasn't very, you know. So how do you average it out? I get for the flow.
Yeah.
I give it a 4.
For me, it was like average, so I'm gonna give it a 5.
Okay.
We'll say 4.5. I really wanted to go to 6, but nothing was getting me above nothing that average feeling of like just mediocre kind of. Anyway, lyrical content.
And we know, and I think one of the reasons that this is so hard is, like I said before, we know. And even though I'm not a big fan of the other things that Kendrick has done, I know from other pieces of things that he's been in that he can do a lot better than that.
I liked his, since we're on lyrical content, I liked Kendrick's lyrical content a little more.
Oh, it was way better.
So that sort of boosts the score.
It was such a small section of it.
Yeah, yeah. So for lyrical content, I have to give it a 4 just because some of it was just, it was just ineffectual, and I think like it had no direction. At first it had a direction, then they totally undermined their own song with like that shit at the end, and then like, yeah, I don't know. So what between did I say? 4.
Yeah. Between the situational good lines that I thought Lil Wayne had that I thought were reasonably clever, and then Kendrick coming in and making it, you know, fun for a minute and kind of re-engaging you with the content a little bit.
Yeah.
I'm just going to give it a 5.
Okay.
For its totality. It ended up being like the content of it. The beat
was the best part of the song.
Oh, yeah.
It was. By far. And there was a lot of changes and interesting.
Yeah.
The thing with the flute and then the organ. I heard organ in there.
Yeah.
Some string stuff in one part.
Yeah.
So it was pretty intricate.
It was tense, too, at the same time. Like, it was compelling. And
I think, like you said, like, the vocals didn't come up to that level of the beat.
Kind
of
like,
which is a shame.
Like, when you're playing piano or you're playing guitar, you know, there's like a void notes or there's tension notes where you're like, you can go here to be like, how's this going to resolve? And you don't want to sit there too long because it ruins it and it makes it just kind of go flat or go off. But if you introduce them strategically, it creates just a little bit of suspense, a little bit of intrigue in the beat.
Mm-hmm.
And
it had a lot of subtlety to it.
Like the strategic implementation of like really small things like that flute, that like nice light flourish
accents.
But it was funny because we had the palate cleanser because I was really getting lost. And then as soon as we got back from the palate cleanser, the little flute came in.
Yeah,
and it was like
clouds open.
It was almost like the they knew like we might lose some people here. We need a little flourish.
No, that beat kept it interesting.
Yeah.
That's what really kept us from totally, like, shutting
just
it off.
Just losing it, yeah.
I give it an 8. What do you...
Yeah.
No, it's kind of high, but there's a lot of, like...
But there was a lot of clever things done with it.
Yeah, it was smart. Really smart.
It makes sense.
Is that what you think?
Yeah. Right.
Production was good, too, I think.
Actually, I mean, certain things of the production got me. Like the...
Like, oh,
the,
you didn't like it?
Like, the compression on the voice, it was, like, really, like,
well,
squashed.
Yeah, I'm thinking more, like, the production of the beat, with the beat.
Yeah.
But, yeah, you're right, the voice, like but we mentioned earlier.
The totality of the song, though.
Yeah, the voice at the beginning felt a little hollow, like you said.
Yeah.
And I don't know.
Like, there wasn't any real weight to it. It was thin.
I just think, in general, the vocals sounded separate from the beat. In many ways,
yeah.
The sound and what was happening, like
maybe two different people mixed them.
Yeah.
So,
what do you think for production? I mean, there were those cool vocal effects too. That you
yeah,
mentioned.
I did like the delay.
Yeah. I'd say seven. For
I
production.
Was gonna say seven.
Seven.
Seven works.
Yeah.
Tally it up, bitch.
So I think the beat in this one kind of saved this from being a total travesty.
Total bummer. A stone cold bummer.
Six.
Just above average. A six for Mona Lisa by Lil Wayne featuring Kendrick Lamar.
That's the way I felt about it. It would have been just average if that beat wasn't that good. It would have probably been below average.
Oh, it would have been way worse. Yeah.
All right. Well, that's it. That's a wrap.
That's a wrap.
Make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe.
Yeah.
Hit that notification button.
Give us the thumbs up, because our egos are fragile. Because we're grown-ups. But yeah.
But yeah,
thanks
I think
watching.
Like
also, we should say thank you to all of our new subscribers.
Yeah.
I'm happy to report that
I
was wrong by thinking that the Eminem video wasn't going to, because I really didn't. Because I didn't think that, like, Suicide Boys people cared as much. But at the same time,
well, you gotta think everyone...
I wasn't thinking about, you know, like, YouTube's algorithms feeding the word Eminem to a lot of people who search for Eminem. And so now I think we have...
Well, plus we also assume that everyone hates us. Really.
Yeah.
It's not, well, even Eminem's not going to save us.
Fat fuck on the right. But yeah, so thanks for subscribing. I'm glad to have some new people.
Yeah, it's cool to have people who are into different stuff,
too.
Yeah,
thanks for showing your support of this totally dumb thing we're doing. But you guys, you guys have a great night.
To the Lions.
To the Lions.